Hi everyone, Cody here. So I've been hiking around most of the day, and in fact, I'm now off the ranch. If I think about it, the ranch should be that way a couple of miles, and I'm actually currently on public lands, and behind me is the thing I've been looking for. Yeah, right back there. This mine, they were actually mining mercury here. Let's go get a little bit closer look at that. So yeah, here's the entrance to the mine here. You can see that somebody's been in there recently. With some beer cans, but you'll notice that all of the wood is actually fairly new. Now, my dad says that he was over here when he was a little kid and they were still mining this. I think they were still mining in here till the 80s, so that would mean this wood's only like, 40 years old? Not even 40? Maybe even closer to 30? Yeah. You see, that was probably bought at Home Depot. Probably one of the newer mines in the area. Yeah, I don't want to go in there today, mostly because I don't have a light, and second, I have no idea what's back there. There could be a hole in the ground that's covered up with stuff, and I would never know. So, let's actually head back out and go look at the thing that I actually wanted to come out here for. Now, I actually brought my other camera. You can see it right here. May as well pick this back up. Now, unfortunately, this thing is a brick right now, because I packed the wrong battery and I don't have a way to get it to run again. So, unfortunately, I'm using my cell phone here. But anyway, right down there is the thing I wanted to come over here and look at. And here it is. If my sources are correct, this should be a mercury still. They were actually distilling the mercury right here. Now, it looks kind of weird, and I actually don't know how it works. But, yeah, they were definitely roasting something. See, there's a firebox in there. Looks like a hopper. A bunch of sticks in it. So, yeah. My objective for today was to have a look at this and see how it works. Okay. So I'm up standing over the hopper here. You see, it's mostly got sticks and stuff that has fallen down in it. I've been trying to dig this out a little bit using this, what I assume is some sort of rake to see exactly where those tubes go. So I'm still digging those out, but I'm also finding some rocks in here. So pull one of those up towards me. Let's see. Yeah, this rock, it doesn't look like ore to me. In fact, most of the rocks in here appear to be more or less random. Like somebody's thrown them in. Let's see, there's a white one there. Looks like calcite. Let's pull that up. That looks promising. Oh yeah, there we go. There's some cinnabar right there. This red spot, a little bit different color than you would see with iron. See, here's some iron staining right there. You see how the cinnabar is a much darker red. Yeah, so here's our ore right here. In fact, if I'm not mistaken, there's another piece right there. There we go. Definitely what I would expect to find associated with the cinnabar. And looks like mostly iron staining there. I'm sure if I broke it open and looked at it a little closer, I might find something. But yeah, so that's the ore they're using. And I'm assuming that this thing was filled. Am I zoomed in? No. I'm assuming this hopper here was filled with the ore. And then it fed down into the heat box down there. So this would have been full of fire. It would have gotten hot. Let me look at this a little bit more. Okay, so it looks like the ore would come down this big square chute. And then I've got this pipe right here that goes through it somehow. And that goes down into here where it'd be heated by a fire. Okay?
Okay, so my current hypothesis is that the rock, after it's been roasted and heated up, comes out this chute here. And air, I'm thinking, would be sucked in here. Possibly there's some holes that had mixed the air with the rock. Not entirely sure on that. Looks like there's a little bit of a corrosion here. Maybe I could bust this open and see what's inside. Let's see here. Looks like there are some rocks in there. You know what? That looks like a piece of lime, which I'm assuming was calcite, which has been heated up. Excellent. Hypothesis verified. So the ore did come in here, then out here. Looking in there, I don't really see a connection. But I'm assuming there is one. So my thoughts are that the mercury vaporizes from the rock, and then it gets pulled, along with heated air, up this pipe, which goes around, comes down here, and up that stack. Now the top of that is capped off, I've looked at it. And then the hot gases would go down this little pipe there, and then there's a second stack coming up. So I'm assuming the mercury would settle down at the bottom of these things and get collected. So I dug down on this, and it appears that either this piece of steel is completely rotted off or it was open at the end. So there must have been a collection vessel right down there to collect the mercury. Possibly even something that like screwed on. You can see it a little bit better over on this side. See, this one's also about the same. Looks like it's quite a bit rotted, but it used to have some threads on there, so they might have had a bottle or something to catch the mercury. And this tube right here is vented to the atmosphere. So yeah, these are the condensation columns to collect the mercury. Awesome. So the rock could go down this hopper, down this chute, get heated up in this box till it's red hot, then air would pass over it, being sucked in because it's buoyant. The air would go up through this pipe, down there, up here, and it'd get cooled off, and then it'd go down this one, and up that one, get finished cooling. What an awesome piece of engineering. Okay, that's all I wanted to know. I guess I'll go back to my own mine. Okay, so I'm back at the ranch. I've got a battery for my camera, and there's an outcrop of cinnabar ore behind me here, which I've extracted mercury from in the past. Now, the cinnabar ore here is a little bit different than what's on the other side of the mountain. You can see here, it's got sandstone instead of the calcite, as you can see there. Now, I would argue and say that the ore is actually the same. It's just had a little bit of different chemistry happen to it since it was formed. The rock that's associated with the ore that was on the other side of the mountain is the same. It is sandstone, and it's got those little red specks throughout it, and it does, of course, contain cinnabar. The thing that's mainly different here is the fact that there's no calcite, but I would actually venture and say that there used to be calcite here. In fact, there was probably veins of calcite, just like this, and because the conditions on this side of the mountain were a little bit more acidic, the calcite has dissolved away over time, leaving these nice, smooth pieces of cinnabar behind. The coloring is a little bit different, but I would actually say that that's probably due to the fact that this has been hot at one point. I'm not sure if that was because it was in the hopper next to the fire, or if there was a forest fire that came through and heated it up. But yes, it's gotten a little bit hotter. The color is similar. It could also be due to the fact that the crystal size in this one is a little bit larger than this one. So the ore here is very similar to what they have on the other side of the mountain, but I'd say that the quality here is quite a bit lower, which is why that I personally has only been able to extract maybe about a pound of mercury from it. So that raises the question, where on earth did I get hundreds and hundreds of pounds of mercury to flush down a toilet? If you've seen that video, I'll link over there somewhere. The answer to that is actually that a lot of the mercury did come from over on the other side of the mountain. my grandpa was friends with them, and mercury wasn't actually what they were mining for mostly. They were actually after the gold, which is associated with the cinnabar. See, the cinnabar actually contains a very small amount of gold in it. And what they were doing is they were roasting it out, they were extracting the mercury, and then they'd save the rock, and they'd crush it up, probably did a cyanide process to it to leach out the gold. And as far as I know, they were actually selling the mercury until the price of mercury dropped, and they still had a bunch of mercury they wanted to get rid of, and my grandpa took several flasks off their hands, and that's the mercury I have today. That's not all of the mercury I've got, though. I did have a dentist, or actually the son of a dentist, down in California. He had a bunch of little one-pound bottles of dental mercury. He wanted to get rid of them. I was someone who was very experienced with working with mercury, and so I took them off his hands. So I hope that answers some of the questions you had. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.